My name is Jean Flagg Newton. I'm the Assistant Director, Office of Health Equity, the Eunice Kennedy Shriver National Institute of Child Health and Human Development. Hello, everyone. I'm going to share some points with you about professional development for research administrators. The NIH A capacity building program for research administrators is one of its oldest programs, and yet during the time frame of that program, the field of research administration has grown tremendously. And so we have numerous lessons learned, both from our experiences with the program, as well as for the growing field of research administration. What we like to do today is to look at six primary areas, and we will look from a historical perspective to staffing offices of research administration to obtaining and maintaining a certification in research administration. Historically, research administrators actually came in waves. We began in around 1940 with the government-sponsored laboratories, and most of the research administrators were actually scientists. The next wave of research administrators included military officers, scientists, as well as business managers. The third wave came out of the universities. They were trained at the universities in diverse fields, and they actually staffed the various offices at colleges and universities. And the fourth wave of research administrators actually included a diverse group of people with diverse backgrounds, and many of them started to secure training opportunities in various training programs that are sponsored by the Society of Research Administrators. In order to inform professional development, what we have to do is take a look at the functions of research administrators. The research administrators actually work at the interface of the research project, the institution, and the sponsor. From time to time, they have diverging interests. So the research administrator becomes an interpreter, a mediator, and an expediter as well. Research administrators also seek to provide services, services to increase the success of the researchers. They look after the interest of the institutions to make sure that their regulations are followed. They are also responsible for ensuring that the goals of the sponsors are met, as well as following their regulations. Historically, the functions of research administrators were quite process-driven. However, with increased competition for funding sources, research administrators have been encouraged to think more strategically and to provide offices of opportunity. Research administrators are now being encouraged to become leaders and to become strategic thinkers in terms of helping institutions to implement their research programs. Let's think about what skill sets are needed for research administrators. They interpret regulations, they communicate at various levels, and they problem solve. And so these are the kinds of skills that you will look at when you start looking for new staff. In terms of filling the offices, one has to think about the size of your portfolio, whether it warrants full-time employees, or whether you need to start by expanding the role of existing employees. When you get beyond that point, you might start to fill entry-level jobs from the local pool. You must remember that in addition to the three skills that I mentioned before of interpreting regulations, communicating at various levels, and problem solving. You need employees who are self-starters and who will take the initiative to learn, because there are few programs that will start them from the beginning in terms of providing them with the expertise that's needed. Let's talk about research administration as a profession. When we think about a profession, we think about a group of people with certain skills. Their expertise is guided by certain codes and requirements, and they must sit for exams and things like that. And so, as the scope of research administration became increasingly broad, with more dissemination of regulations, then it became necessary to really think about research administration as a profession, to start thinking about career ladders and things of that nature. The major areas of emphasis for research administrators, you think in terms of pre-award, those activities that happen prior to the submission of an application to a funding agency. This includes things like stimulating research, professional development for faculty, and providing technical expertise in terms of developing applications for research funding. Then you think about the award process. Once the award is made by the funding institution, you think about setting up spending accounts, acquisition of products for research, paying staff, and things like that. And finally, you think of post-award. These are requirements mostly by the funding agency and some by the institution. And it has to do with managing the research to make sure that it is accomplished, as well as the reporting requirements required by funding agencies. Now, thinking about the broad dimensions of research administration, the skills that are needed, what type of training challenges do we have? Well, again, you think about the broad dimensions, the fact that there is a broad requirement in terms of regulations. You have to understand the research that's ongoing at your institution. You have to understand the business processes. You have to understand the application requirements of funding agencies. And the new added challenge is, of course, electronic research administration. So these are areas that your staff will have to be well-versed in, and they have to be continuous learners because these things keep changing. In terms of the type of training for research administrators, it will range from on-the-job training to actually certification courses that are provided by private companies, to master's levels programs that are provided either online or one might attend in person. This is the range of training opportunities that you might have. And we can summarize it another way. We can say that staff will begin with individual training plans. They will move on to the various tracks that are offered by the Society for Research Administrators International, or the programs that are provided by the National Council of University Research Administrators. For more senior level people, you will attend the special seminars at these regional meetings or national meetings. And these will be great opportunities to learn more, to find out what the status of the field is, and as it were, to sort of sit at the feet of those who really have a lot of experience in research administration. And finally, how do we obtain a certification in research administration, and how do we maintain it? Well, first, what is a certification, and why become certified? Well, firstly, a certification is a type of guarantee or an endorsement by a specific body of people that tells you that certain people have a certain level of expertise and are able to function at different levels, from the beginning level on up to the most senior level. Why become certified? Well, a lot of reasons. It's for professional recognition, but also many administrators have to work with faculty, and these certifications go a long ways in making faculty feel more comfortable with you. Also, it provides advanced opportunities and a number of other reasons why you would want to become certified. What do you do? Well, first, you have to meet the requirements of the Research Administrators Certification Council. You have to study the body of knowledge, which is maintained by the Research Administrators Certification Council, and you have to pass exams. There are two tracks, one in general research administration and one that focuses primarily on pre-award research administration. What is the RAC? The Research Administration Certification Council. They are a group of volunteers from all over, from universities, from hospitals, from other research institutions, as well as some government research administrators are members of the RAC as well. Okay, they developed the certification program and they administer the certification program. They maintain the bodies of knowledge. There are two bodies of knowledge, one for general research administration and one for pre-award research administration. How do you prepare for exam? Well, the first thing that you do is that you have to be in the practice. You have to be employed as a research administrator. You need to meet certain education requirements or experience requirements. You will need to identify training tracks that you would like to follow. And most importantly, you need to join the listserv of others who are in the process of studying for certification. The most successful research administrators are those who study as a part of a group. In our program for research administrators, I can tell you that our experience is that two actually secured their certification in about 6 months. Of course, these were two of my fast burners. What do you do to remain certified? Every 5 years, you have to do something. You recertify. For the general certification in research administration, you need to make sure that during the 5 years that you continue the practice, you continue either to teach research administration or you participate in courses for research administration, and you must have about 80 continuing contact hours where you've either worked in research administration in terms of teaching it or in terms of taking courses. And you contribute 3 new questions to the body of knowledge for use in future exams. There is no requirement for re-exam for the general research administration track. But for pre-award administration, in addition to meeting the continuing education requirements, one has to resit for that exam every 5 years. And this is what I wanted to share with you about research administration. We learned during the experience with our program that training in research administration is a must, and so we encourage our grantees to do so. We also encourage you to work with groups while you're working toward your certification in research administration. Thank you very much.